What's up, world? This is Brad from Project Build Stuff, and today we're going to go over 5 tips and tricks that make using the CNC so much easier. Let's go. Tip 1 has to begin with the computer because every CNC project starts with a computer. What is the best way to design up your project? Many new CNC users begin with 2D carving. In order to do a 2D carve, you must start with a design. I like to do all of my designing in a third-party software, such as Adobe Illustrator or Inkscape. In both softwares, all you have to do is export your design as an SVG file in order to upload it in Easel or Carbide Create. The next step is going to be to upload your SVG file into your CNC software. In my case, that's Easel. Now that our file is uploaded, we can set our tool paths. Tool paths tell the CNC how and where to carve. For this sign, I want to cut the inside letters out to put up on a wall. So I want a full depth of carve to go all the way through the material, and I want to cut on the line so it's true to my design. The boring computer work is almost over. The last step I do before carving is to set my center point as the 0 for my bit. This makes it much easier to set up a carve on an odd-shaped object like this complicated sign. Don't worry about your design disappearing from the preview on the right. We'll deal with that in a bit. Our file is all ready to go. Tip number 2 is all about how we're going to hold it in place. Holding down most materials only requires a few tools. A couple of cam clamps, an impact driver, and most importantly, a number 4 hex bit. Why struggle like this when you can do this? With a large board like this, you can still have some wobble. That's where wasteboard clamps come in. And just like that, we're clamped and ready to go. Let's carve. And as quick as they go on, they come right back off. Tip number 3, let's get our bit in the perfect position. In tip 1, we set the origin point at the center of our design. So we're gonna mark a spot in the center of our material so we know where to home to. While most CNC programs have built-in controls to home your router, I find it easier to turn off the CNC and hand home the router. It can be far more accurate and quicker most of the time. Hey, that logo's familiar. Just right. And don't forget dust collection, unless you like cleaning up messes. Do you have some thin or odd-shaped stock you want to cut? Then tip 4 is for you. Woodworker's best friends, activator, CA glue, and painter's tape. The key to this hold-down method is that your strips of painter's tape are evenly spaced on your material and on the wasteboard. Remember, a little CA glue goes a long way. You don't want to glue your material to your wasteboard forever. Cutting out a couple extra cam clamps without even a wiggle. When you're ready to remove your piece, just give it a little pull and even the strongest painter's tape will come loose. And we made it. Tip number 5. This one's great for all you new CNC users out there. Let's talk a little about projects. Inventables has an awesome collection of pre-designed projects that's perfect for new CNC users who are just trying to get their feet wet with a new machine. Hey look, it's Jay and Jamie. Oh, and Evan and Caitlin. Inventables has partnered with a ton of awesome makers to make great designs. Let's check out some shop gear. This is one of my favorite sections. It has tons of projects that make organizing and using your CNC way easier. Let's look at those cam clamps we were using earlier.
Every project has beautiful pictures so you can see what the final product will look like. Some even have SVG files you can download and edit yourself. If you're an easel user, using these projects is as simple as hitting the blue Open an Easel button. Here's just a small selection of some of the projects I've downloaded. Everything from organization to beautiful bowls.
You might not be a CNC expert yet, neither am I, but hopefully you learned something in today's video. The CNC can be quite intimidating, but just keep at it. If you like what you saw here today, go check me out on Instagram at projectbuildstuff, and be sure to like and subscribe down below to check out my future videos. And as always, it's your turn. Go build stuff.